A very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to continue our chapter judiciary, and under that one topic was left, that was judiciary and rights. Judiciary is that body which settles all the disputes between various organs of the government, and our constitution provides two ways in which Supreme Court of India can protect our fundamental rights and it can remedy the violation of rights. अगर किसी व्यक्ति के फंडामेंटल राइट्स वायलेट होते हैं तो ऐसी कंडीशन में सुप्रीम कोर्ट अपना रोल अदा करता है. फर्स्ट सिचुएशन में फर्स्ट वे एक अजिहा तरीका है दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन द अर्लियर चैप्टर राइट्स दैट राइट्स टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडी. किसी एक व्यक्ति के फंडामेंटल राइट्स नू रिस्टोर करन दे ले सुप्रीम कोर्ट कुछ रिट्स इशू करता है under article number 32. Such writs are habeas corpus, mandamus and so on. And high courts also have this power to issue the writs under article number 226. Means high court or supreme court, dono hi, they are the protector of fundamental rights of common citizens of India. And under second way, supreme court can declare any concerned law unconstitutional and non-operational under article 13 of Indian constitution. Kise bhi law nu supreme court unconstitutional declare kar sakta hai je oh dekhda hai that a particular right particular law is inconsistent with the constitution of India. In that situation that law can be unoperational or non-operational. इट मीन्स सुप्रीम कोर्ट दो काम करता है. एट वन सिचुएशन इट इज़ द प्रोटेक्टर ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स ऑफ द सिटीजन्स एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड इट इज़ द इंटरप्रेटर ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑल्सो. मीन्स अगर कोई लॉ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के अकॉर्डिंगली नहीं बनाया गया तो ऐसी कंडीशन में सुप्रीम कोर्ट उस पर्टिकुलर लॉ को नॉन ऑपरेशनल घोषित कर देता है. Now let us discuss what is judicial review. Under judicial review, it is the power of the Supreme Court or High Court to examine the constitutionality of any law. That a particular law is according to the Constitution, it is consistent to the Constitution, and if a court, whether Supreme Court or High Court, if it is declared in the court that particular law is inconsistent, it is not according to the provisions of the constitution, in that situation that law is declared as unconstitutional and inapplicable. Koi bhi law supreme court high court apne discussion to baad it decide karda hai ki a law constitution de accordingly hai ki nahi hai. Te je oh constitution de कंसिस्टेंट नहीं साबित होता तो ऐसे लॉ को लागू नहीं किया जाता. दैट इज नो दैट इज डिक्लेयर्ड एज अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल कि ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के अगेंस्ट है और दैट इन दैट सिचुएशन ऑल्सो इट इज नो इट इज़ नॉट एप्लीकेबल. एक्चुअली जुडिशियल रिव्यू साढ़े कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में कितने भी नहीं मैनशन किया गया. बट सिंस इंडिया हैज़ अ रिटन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन and supreme court can strike down a law that goes against the fundamental rights implicitly gives supreme court the power of judicial review. kyunki jadon bhi koi bhi law fundamental rights se against janda hai to supreme court khada hokar usnu unconstitutional announce karda hai aur ise power nu assi constitution di supreme court di judicial review di shakti kehnde ha. This is a very important para. This can be asked in one in passage based also. The next is Supreme Court can use the review power from here. Supreme Court can review can use the review powers if a law is inconsistent with the distribution of powers laid by the Constitution. Tanu pata hi hai ek central government hai ek state government hai. यूनियन गवर्नमेंट सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एक ही है जी सेंटर दे विच है इंडिया दे विच. मान लो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने कोई ऐसा कानून बनाया है ਜੋ ਕੁਝ ਸਟੇਟਸ ਇਹ ਸਮਝਦੇ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਕਾਨੂੰਨ ਸਟੇਟ ਲਿਸਟ ਦੇ ਅੰਡਰ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਦੈਨ ਦੋਸ ਪਾਰਟਿਕੂਲਰ ਸਟੇਟਸ ਕੈਨ ਗੋ ਟੂ ਦਾ ਸੁਪਰੀਮ ਕੋਰਟ ਐਂਡ ਇਫ ਦਾ ਕੋਰਟ ਐਗਰੀਜ਼ ਵਿਦ ਦੈਮ ਇਟ ਡਿਕਲੇਅਰ ਦੈਟ ਪਾਰਟਿਕੂਲਰ ਲਾਅ ਅਨਕੋਨਸਟੀਟਿਊਸ਼ਨਲ ਜੇਕਰ ਸੈਂਟਰਲ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਕਿਸੇ ਲਾਅ ਕੋਈ ਵੀ ਲਾਅ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਿ ਸਟੇਟ ਸਬਜੈਕਟ 'ਤੇ ਹੈ ਕੁਛ ਸਟੇਟਸ ਮੰਨਦੇ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਲਾਅ ਸੁਪਰੀਮ ਸੈਂਟਰਲ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਦੁਆਰਾ ਬਣਾਇਆ ਗਿਆ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਸਟੇਟ ਸਬਜੈਕਟ ਦਾ ਮੈਟਰ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਐਸੀ ਸਿਚੁਏਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੁਛ ਸਟੇਟਸ ਮਿਲ ਕੇ ਸੁਪਰੀਮ ਕੋਰਟ ਕੋਲ ਅਪਰੋਚ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਜੇ ਕੋਰਟ ਵੀ ਮੰਨ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਐਸੀ ਸਿਚੁਏਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਸ ਲਾਅ ਨੂੰ ਅਨਕੋਨਸਟੀਟਿਊਸ਼ਨਲ ਘੋਸ਼ਿਤ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਸੈਂਸ ਰਿਵਿਊ ਪਾਵਰ ਆਫ ਦਾ ਸੁਪਰੀਮ ਕੋਰਟ ਇਟ ਇੰਕਲੂਡਸ ਪਾਵਰ ਟੂ ਰਿਵਿਊ ਦਾ ਲੈਜਿਸਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਜਿੰਨੇ ਵੀ ਲਾਅਜ਼ ਬਣਾਏ ਗਏ ਨੇ ਸੈਂਟਰਲ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਦੇ ਦੁਆਰਾ ਸੁਪਰੀਮ ਕੋਰਟ ਕੋਲ ਇਹ ਸ਼ਕਤੀ ਆ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਲੈਜਿਸਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਨੂੰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਲਾਅ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸ ਨੂੰ ਰਿਵਿਊ ਕਰ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ ਐਂਡ ਇਫ ਦੇ ਵਾਇਲੇਟ ਦਾ ਫੰਡਾਮੈਂਟਲ ਰਾਈਟਸ ਔਰ ਇਫ ਦੇ ਵਾਇਲੇਟ ਦਾ ਫੈਡਰਲ ਡਿਸਟ੍ਰੀਬਿਊਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਪਾਵਰਸ ਇਨ ਦੈਟ ਸਿਚੁਏਸ਼ਨ ਜੁਡੀਸ਼ਰੀ ਔਰ ਸੁਪਰੀਮ ਕੋਰਟ ਕੈਨ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ ਐਂਡ ਇਟ ਕੈਨ ਅਨਾਊਂਸ ਇਟ ਕੈਨ ਡਿਕਲੇਅਰ ਦੈਟ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰ ਲਾਅ ਅਨਕੋਨਸਟੀਟਿਊਸ਼ਨਲ The review power extend to the laws passed by the state legislature also. Jadi judicial review di shakti hai, judicial review tanu hun tak pata ho gaya, hun tak pata lag gaya hona, that it is the power of the Supreme Court or the High Court to examine the constitutionality of any law. In the same way, the judicial review power of Supreme Court, it extends to the laws passed by the state legislature also. Judicial review particularly assi mande ha ki judiciary can interpret the constitution and the laws passed by the legislature. A constitution on the definition onu interpret bhi kardi hai judiciary de naal it also interpret the legislature, the laws passed by the Parliament of India and by the state legislature of India. And moreover, the practice of using public interest litigation, it has further added the powers of judiciary in protecting the rights of the common people. If we see that if you remember that this right, some of the rights were mentioned against under the right against exploitation, and this rights, for example, forced labor is being seen, trade in human flesh, prohibits employment of children in hazardous jobs. These are all because these people can't go to the courts. A child, a culprit of trade in human flesh, if one has seen in this situation, the victim of forced labor, they can't approach the court. In that situation, social organizations, some voluntary organization or a person can approach the court and file a petition on their behalf. So public interest litigation or judicial activism, it had made possible for the court to consider these violations. Some situations, some violation of fundamental rights have been seen in some of the cases like blinding of the jail inmates by the police, inhuman working conditions in stone quarries, khano mein jo sexual exploitation of the children, and so on. In these cases, fundamental rights have been violated, and this PIL, this has made rights really meaningful for the poor and disadvantaged section. Jo log gareeb hain, disadvantaged hain, they can't approach the court, and in that situation, public interest litigation under petitions are filed by a voluntary organization or some lawyers or some social organizations on the behalf of the victim. And this has made the access of fundamental rights to every poor and disadvantaged section. This is all with today's topic. Thank you. Have a nice day.